In this video, I'm going to show you how you can perform a two-way ANOVA in SPSS. So in our one-way ANOVA video, we looked at diet and we had three diets, and then we looked at total weight loss of people that had either taken diet one, two, or three. Now in a two-way ANOVA, what we are doing is we are now going to add gender as an extra independent variable. And just so you know, if we decided to add another independent variable, that would become a three-way ANOVA, and you can keep adding variables to be a four or five-way ANOVA. So as before, we would go to Analyze and we would go to General Linear Model. We then go to Univariate, and then here we have all of our different variables. So before, we had our total weight loss as our dependent variable, and then we had diet as our grouping variable. This is what we were looking at, the difference in weight loss, the average weight loss of the different diets. Now we are also going to add this extra category of gender here. There are a few more buttons that we need to look at now. So if we go to Model, here is where we can, if we choose, to test for what we call an interaction term. The default is an interaction term, but some data are not suitable for an interaction term. And if this is the case, you have to click Custom, and then on the drop down, you have to go to Main Effects, and then you would press Continue. And I will show you what I mean by different types of data. So in our two-way ANOVA, we have three different sets of alternative hypotheses. So first of all, we are looking to see if the diets are significantly different or not. We're looking to see if the gender is significantly different or not in weight loss, but we are also looking to see if there is an interaction between diet and gender. And I mentioned how different data can be suitable for the different situations. So when you have not got any replication of a combination, so for example, treatment A with this group of ages here, we haven't got any replication. That's the only value we have for this particular set here. So this means we'd have to use a main effects term and we couldn't use an interaction term. However, with these sorts of data, which are very similar to the ones that we're going to be using, but obviously a lot less, you can see that we do have replication for males within diet one, with females within diet one, and so on for the different diets. So these data are suitable for an interaction term. So if we go back here, there are other buttons that we are going to have to look at. So plots is a button that you might want to look at. This is going to be helpful when we look at the interaction term. So we move diet over into the horizontal, and I'm going to move gender into the separate. And then I'm going to add them here. So when you see this little asterisk in between the two, this is often looking at the two together. So often this will be looking at an interaction. This is to help us with a graph. As before, we have our post-hoc test here. Now, post-hoc test isn't going to work for gender because we've only got two groups. So it just won't work. So there's no point me moving that over. So I'm going to put diet and I'm going to put Tukey. Now, had there been more than two groups for gender, I would have moved this over. And then going to press continue. Now, if we hadn't done the one-way ANOVA before and we didn't know whether or not our data followed a normal distribution or not, remember that we would tick this button here and we would make a column of data with our residuals, which we could then test for a normal distribution. So if you want to see how to do that, check out the one-way ANOVA video. But we already know that our data follow a normal distribution, so I'm going to leave that one for now. Then if we go to options, we can just double make sure we've got information that we might need. So we might want the homogeneity tests, although this already should be okay. We have done this previously, but let's just do it again. And then we've got our descriptive statistics. And some of you might be interested in the estimates of effect size, so I'm just going to tick that too. Press continue, and that should be everything that we need for now. Now I'm going to press OK. Our output window appears. I'll just maximize that. It takes a few moments to run. So we've got information about our groups. So how many of our samples fall into these different diets and how many fall into these different genders. Then we have our descriptive statistics. So remember, this is useful because you might want to see the means of your particular groups. So here the weight loss for females is 3 kilograms, whereas for males we've got 3.6. So it depends on the diet as well. We've got three different diets. So these are the weight losses within the diets for the males and females. So this will become useful later if our ANOVA is significantly different and if our Tukeys are significantly different. Olivine's test for equality of variance is telling us that we do have equality because we haven't been able to prove that otherwise. We've not got significantly different data from that of equal variance. And as I said, don't forget, you must test your normality assumption as well, particularly if you have less than about 25 to 30 samples. Here is our table that is similar to the ANOVA that you saw previously, except we've got a few extra groups. So here, along diet, this is similar to what we recorded earlier in the one-way ANOVA, but this time there's a lot more going on. So what we are seeing here is this is our test statistic for diet, 4.6. This is our p-value, which as you can see is less than 0.05, and that means it is significantly different. There was significantly different weight loss for diet when we look at that on its own. We then go to gender on its own. Was there a significant difference between men and women just on their own, not taking diet into consideration? And what we find here is actually there is no significant difference when we just simply look at men and women and we ignore the diets that they had. But when we look at an interaction term, and that's what this little asterisk means here, between diet and gender, oh, it just about manages to fall under 0.05. So this means there is a significant difference, or there is a significant interaction happening between diet and gender. So what this means is that in one of the diets, there is something different happening with one of the genders compared to some of the others as well. I ticked the partial eta squared. Some of you might be interested in this. So this is the effect size, and it's telling us how much of the variance is made up by these different factors. So 11% of our variance is made up by the diet, and then we have 8%, sorry, there we go. Then we have 8% of the variance is made up by the interaction term of diet and gender. If we move down here, we now have our post-hoc Tukey tests. These are going to show something similar to the ones we saw earlier, i.e. that diet 3 is significantly different to diets 1 and 2, but 1 and 2 are not significantly different. So that's great, but at the moment, we know we have an interaction term, but we don't know what's happening. We know it's significant. So this is why it was useful for us to click on the plots on the graphs. So what you can see here is we've got in diet 1 that females don't have as much weight loss as men. They also don't have as much weight loss in diet 2 as men do, but then suddenly we've got a switch around. Suddenly females have got a lot more average weight loss than males when it comes to diet 3. So this is where our interaction term is picking up a difference. It's when this line crosses. If this line had remained parallel, then we probably wouldn't have seen any significant difference for the interaction term. So hopefully that has given you an overview of how a two-way ANOVA works.